You know, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life.
Today is Wednesday, November 2nd, 2022. My name is Hunter. Happy birthday to Kingston and Mrs. Sims' class, and Leah in Mrs. Wagaman's class. Stay tuned for the core value announcement about courage.
Our core value this month is courage. The internet is littered with one-liners about those who have overcome failure and setbacks. Nick Woodman, the inventor of the GoPro, lost over $4 million trying to get his invention off the ground. It takes courage to share your vision and invention. You have to be brave enough to do something even when you're afraid.
Things that make you go, what? November 2nd, 1947. On November 2nd, the Howard Hughes flying boat is piloted by designer Howard Hughes on its first and only flight. Built with laminated birch and spruce, hence the nickname the Spruce Goose, the massive wooden aircraft had a wingspan longer than a football field and was designed to carry more than 700 men to battle. Howard Hughes was a successful Hollywood movie producer when he founded the Hughes Aircraft Company in 1932. He personally tested cutting-edge aircraft on his own design, and in 1937 broke the transcontinental flight time record. Following the U.S. entrance into World War II in 1941, the U.S. government commissioned the Hughes Aircraft Company to build a large flying boat capable of carrying men and materials over long distances. Because of wartime restrictions on steel, Hughes decided to build his aircraft out of wood laminated with plastic and covered with fabric. It had a wingspan of 320 feet and was powered by 8 giant propeller engines. Development of the Spruce Goose cost a phenomenal $23 million and took so long that the war had ended by the time of its completion in 1946. On November 2nd, 1947, Hughes obliged taking the H-4 prototype out into Long Beach Harbor, California for an unannounced flight test. Thousands of onlookers had come to watch the aircraft taxi on the water and were surprised when the plane lifted some 70 feet in the air. Despite its successful maiden voyage, the Spruce Goose never went into production. Today, the Spruce Goose is housed at the Evergreen Aviation Museum in McMinnville, Oregon.
Let's end today's announcements by remembering the STAR expectations. Today and every day, strive to do your best.
Take responsibility for your actions.
Always be safe.
Respect people and property. Have a great day, Bearsville!
Now please stand for the playing of the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.